सुप्रभातम सुस्वागतम। कर्मयोगा इज समथिंग वेरी स्पेशल फॉर ऑल अदर स्ट्रीम्स ऑफ योगा, ज्ञान योगा, भक्ति योगा, राजयोगा। यू हैव टू इन्वेस्ट सम स्पेशल टाइम फॉर द प्रैक्टिस, बट कर्मयोगा डज नीड दैट। In Jnana Yoga, you have to spend time to study the Upanishads, Shravana, Manana, Yidhithyatna, and do. Similarly, Raja Yoga, Padma Yoga, we have Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, all these things. Bhakti Yoga, you have got the bhajans and the dimensions related to that. Karma Yoga doesn't need it. Therefore, for very busy activities, always say that I don't have time to practice. Kartavya is the most high. In Karma Yoga, you have to convert the very action into your yoga. Is it ever possible? Even standing, walking, eating, drinking, excreting, urinating, hearing, seeing, talking, everything can be yoga. How is it possible? Not possible. It looks impossible. Krishna says, yes, it is possible. So he says that every action can be a yoga. Pashyan shunvan spashyan dikram ashtam gacchan swapam shvasam pralapam visrujam prunhan unvishan nivishan api indriyan indriyan tesho vartan taitikharayam dashtotai stari pashyan. See, shunvan, hearing, jighran, smelling, pralapan, even crying, visrujan, excretions, all these activities can be converted into yoga. It's not something very wonderful. So what is the secret by which you can do that? Has been explained in the 18 verses that were selected from Bhagavad Gita and we chanted Karma Yoga Shloka Sangraha. So, how to start up the journey? What is that secret? The secret is that you have to understand. You have to understand what is the way by which you do the actions. What propels us to do a particular action in a particular way at all? So we all do our actions. We all do it differently. What is behind which makes us do a work in a particular way? This has to be understood. See. What is that that is behind? This is our personality, traits, gunas. Tamas, Rajas and Sattva, the three gunas. So, we are all born with these three gunas. Some people have more tamas, some people may have more Rajas, some people may have more Sattva. How to find out? Today, thanks to technology, we have now the method to actually measure. You got a questionnaire called VPI, Vedic Personality Inventory. So, we administer that, take the questionnaire, fill it up, you will be able to find out. Oh, I have got 40% tamas, 40% rajas, only 20% sattva. I can make it. So, when I am tamas predominant, when I have too much of tamas, how do I act? If I rajas is more, how do I act? If sattva, how do I act? Krishna gives the verses. Anubandham, Kshayam, Himsa, Anapekshana, Paurusham, Mohadaram, Jyate, Tat Karma, Tamasam, Uchyate. When your tamas predominant, you don't want to do any work. Laziness, lethargy, drowsiness, sleepiness, no. You want to escape action. Kamcho is come up here, no? So, they always want to escape action. Always somebody should be behind supervision. If the Superman is not there, he will sleep up. So this is a domestic action. And if they are forced to do an action without supervision, they do it very haphazardly. And by doing a small work, they use so much of energy. I say, you bring a bulldozer, you kill an ant. That is the fact you're in this place. That is Thomas' action. If a wealth is predominant, what is it? Then you are very sharp, very intelligent, you are a go-getter. And you do all actions wonderfully well. You have good planning, good monitoring, good supervision, and you get the results. And what is behind this rajas? Chitta kamepsana karma, sahankari namapana. That desire, I want to become a millionaire, I want to become a billionaire, I want to become a minister, I want to become a prime minister, I want to become an emperor, I want to be the richest man of the world. Ambition, desire, the purpose you do action. Sahankari namapana, or with it, ahankara. I want to show up everywhere. Arrogance. These are the two things which forms the rajas. They are prepared by the six enemies of man as it is called. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, vada, matsarya, anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, infatuation, arrogance. These are the ones that prepare you to action. And extremely selfish. Everything for me. Don't care for others, cut others, beat others, terrorize others. I want to make my money, I want to make my millennium. So, what is the result of this rajasic action? Kriyate bhurayasam. It brings a lot of fitting unto you, tensions, stresses, and all the hindrances of mortal stress and tension. Asthma, diabetes, hypertension, heart problem, epilepsy, migraine, irritable bowel syndrome, depression, all these mortal ailments and sins, non-communicable disease. Rajas is the back. So the third sattva, when you are sattva predominant, however, you have all the sharpness, brilliance, intelligence, workmanship, everything of rajas. But you have started becoming less and less selfish. I want to give, I want to share, I want to show love and compassion to others, and I want to take less and less for myself, more and more to others. Jivane yavat adhanam syat pradhanam tatrodhikam. Whatever we receive from the society, we should give more from the society. That sattvic dimension starts coming up. So, the three gunas make us act in our particular way, that we act. This is what we have to understand. Then, having understood what is to be done, I have to determine that I want to change. I want to shatter my tamas, reduce my tamas. I want to control my rajas, and I must promote sattva. So once I make a resolve, once I take a determination, then I have to change. But habits die hard. Very difficult to change our resolve. Our habits will continue because we are born with those things, tamas. You know how difficult it is to get up in the morning, 4:30, you are used to get up at 7 o'clock. And the bed is given 4:30, you know. That means sleep for 2 more minutes, 5 o'clock, when you have to go. No, still 30 minutes are there, you sleep. Already it is 7:30. You know, that is the power of tamas, gravitation, ajnana. Therefore, to change habits, you have to make all of our efforts. We all have that freedom, we all have that capacity, we all have that intelligence. You must all have the power to see that you change. Unless you change, the journey doesn't begin. So, day by day, you should go on reducing. Little by little, doesn't matter. But you must go on doing it. Once you determine tamas has to be reduced, rajas has to be reduced, sattva has to be promoted, what to do? The sattvic action, you start developing more and more. How to do that? The three components of sattva have to be developed. Dana, daya, dama. Dana is sharing, giving. Every day must give something. What to give? Okay, if you have money, you give. You have got clothes, you give. You have got food, you give. But you don't have anything. It doesn't matter. What is to be done? Patram, pashpam, phalam, doyam. Yomiya, bhakti, asmaya, bhakti, Krishna says. You give a leaf, give a flower, give a fruit, give a cup of water. Any way in which you can contribute, you must develop that habit of giving, habit of contributing to the institution, to the country, clerk, to your family, to your friends. Some of your constituents are there, they are not understanding the subject properly. You go there and take that. So, this is giving, sharing, compassion, love. You start showing compassion and love. Animals, birds, several other things, you know. And then dhamma, third one. It's called control over the senses. Bahirindriya nigraha dhamma. In Sanskrit, the word dhamma means control over the external senses. Control over the inner senses is shama. Shama and dhamma are the two words. Here dhamma, control over the senses. That means always our senses wants more and more, more and more, more and more. They want to eat faster, faster. No? Then the rush of the senses has to be reduced. No? That is called dhamma, control over the senses. I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this. That all desires should be reduced, reduced, reduced. So if you start bringing up these dimensions, then you are on the sattva. The sattva will start growing. Tamas will reduce. Rajas will reduce. Sattva will grow. So for all people in our university, we take the Vedic Prasad inventory after one semester. Find out what is the change. Whether the reduction in tamas, reduction in rajas, whether the increase in sattva, we measure. You know, if it doesn't happen, you may be very brilliant. You may do very well in the examination. You may get an excellent grade, but you will bring it down to only A. Because yoga brings about the transformation in anything. Unless you change yourself, unless you transform yourself, you are not on the path of yoga. You may do asana, you may pranayama, you may do meditation, all these things you may do, but there is no change in you. You are the same old person. With anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, infatuation, arrogance, cut others, beat others, terrorize others, whatever you are doing, laziness, sleepiness, drowsiness, everything continues, then you are not doing yoga. Anudinam dhanutvamyat arishat vargani. What is the clear proof that you are on the path of yoga? Vasishtha Mahamuni in Yoga Vasishtha says, anudinam, day by day, day by day, day by day, you are arishat vargas. Palm, growth, hello, moha, dhanatha, all thinning out, goes on reducing. This is what Patanjali says in the second chapter. Praise dhanukaranartham. Samadhi bhavana artista. Day by day, your tresha should reduce. You know? Day by day, avidya, ashmita, raga, dvesha, virivesha, all these things should reduce. Thin out. And samadhi bhavana artista. Day must be happier day by day. The healthy health should improve. Your positive health should develop. And more and more ananda should come up. You should become happy, healthier, happier day by day, day by day. And moving towards more and more expansion. Higher visions should happen. So we have been seeing in the second chapter that aspect. Klesha Tanukarana and Samadhi Bhavana. These are the two. But they define what are the kleshas? Avidya, Asmita, Raga, Dvesha, Abhinivesha, Apesha. Having said that, he described what is meant by Avidya, he defines. What is meant by Asmita, he defines. Dashyoho, Ekatma, Yo, Asmita. Raga, that which brings you happiness, sukhanushayi, ragaha, dukkhanushayi, dveshaha. Then abhinivesha is wrong identification. All those kleshas, you know, are to be reduced. That is essentially the rajasic dimensions that are there. So abhinivesha, that will reduce. The next sutra, it says, they have to be reduced from the grassness to this subtle thing. They pratiprasavaheya sushmaha. Let us chant. It is possible to take them back. From here, they have come down and have become grosser and grosser and grosser. So, this is called prasava, creation. Pratiprasava is opposite of creation, going back, evolution, and acceleration back to the source. It's called pratiprasava. So, prasava and pratiprasava. So, we all have known from Anandamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Anandamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Annamaya Kosha. And we have forgotten all of them. So, this is what has happened. This is called prasava. This is what happened, creation. From the causal, it has moved towards the subtle and to the grass. From the karana to sukshma to the sthula. We have become sthula. We have become grass. What is to be done? We have to change. We have to go back to the source. Going back to source means from the grass, you move to the subtle. From the sthula to the sukshma. Therefore, all these things have to be moved towards the sukshma. That is the process of thinning. Therefore, they pratiprasama hiriya, sukshmaha. So, you have to go back by reducing. Your anger should reduce day by day, day by day, day by day. Grass anger. What's happening? In the earlier times, when they get angry with your wife, you have quarrel, go there and hit them. It should be very common. Now, what has happened? The transformation has improved, the whole society has improved. No, I can't hit. And, but I can start using the very sharp words, blames, cream, and everything. That is, the next, from there, that also should not be there. Then the mind, there is the kaya, vacha, manasa, in the mind level. Mind level, you are doing that. Outside, oh, how are you, many are, everything is okay. But inside, you think, come on, I'm going to hit you, finish it. Inside, that has to be controlled, that has to be reduced. Therefore, at all times the himsa should be removed. So, this is the process of the reduction, the pratiprasvahyaya sutra. The next sutra, how to do that? Dhyana heya tad vrittaya. Dhyana heya tad vrittaya. So, tad vrittaya. These modifications of mind which are there, which are causing all these things, they can be reduced by the process of meditation. What is that? Dhyana is going to tell you later. But you have understood, dhyana is a process of slowing down. Uncontrolled speed of the mind, faster mind, quicker mind, we have developed. As a result, you become very angry, very upset, very fast. Small things immediately become angry. And anger takes you to very gross levels. Slow down. So in dhyana, the slowing takes place, slowing of the mind, prashamana takes place. So therefore, by the process of dhyana, by the process of slowing down, you should do that. When you are getting angry, what you should do? You should reduce the speed. How to do that? Take a deep breath. Slow down. You know that you are becoming very angry about something, Then what is your reduce, slow down. That is Jayamiyaha, Tadvrittayaha. Then, why that has happened to us? Why rajas is so much? Why tamas is so much? Why sattva is so less? The root cause is Janma Vedaniyaha. Klesha Moolaha. Karmashayaha drishta adrishta janma vedaniyaha. The root cause for klesha, there is avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, vinivesha. The root cause for that is in the janma vedaniyaha, from the previous birth. That may be seen, that may be unseen. Drishta adrishta. And karmashaya, that is ashaya, the whole seed of the karma, that is the one that brings support. So you do good actions, you have good karma. The samskaras get built up. You do wrong action, you get the wrong karma that comes. This is the theory of karma. As Newton said, action and reactions are equal and opposite. That applies here also. So when you are doing wrong things, you know, anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, this all goes back and creates a karma, karma vishesha, the manomaya kosha called karma ashaya. Ashaya of the karma. That is the story of all karma, karma should be there in the manomaya kosha. And this is the one that gets transferred to your next life. Now we are dead and we take the next birth. Then all these things are stored in the manomaya kosha and come back to you. Good things also come back, bad things also come up. Tamas, rajasa, all these things come back again. All the pleasures come back again. Avidya, asmita, raga, vesha, nirvesha. Whatever is there, it all going to come up. If it is 60%, 70%, all 60-70% comes up. If it is only 20%, 20% comes to you. That's how when we are born, some people are very good, some people are very bad. Some people have a lot of rajasa and tamas. Some people have a lot of sattva. How is it? Because of our previous birth. Therefore, there is a continuation of birth. Therefore, in this birth, in this life, we are all developing positive and two, more and more sattva. Only we build up the sattva to 70% and only 20% tamas and maybe 10% rajas. If we have next janma, you have this thing, 70% sattva. And you can continue further, you can improve. Oh, developing. Therefore, the karmas we are looking there. In the space, all those, the karmas which are hidden in the manomaya kosha, you know, they all have to be, you know, developed and purified. You have to purify all the kosha. That is the process of yoga. Yoga is the process of purification. You know, by the process of purification, you'll be able to completely change yourself. Then you start having a healthy life, you start having a happy life, and you move towards prevention of diseases, suffer less and less, dukkha nivritti happens, sukha prapti happens, and pleksha start getting thinned down, and samadhi start coming up. So this is the whole process. What the thing is, this is what we have to do in karma yoga. In karma yoga, we have to convert every action, you know, towards more and more sattva. Good. Development. When you go on doing it, then you start becoming happier day by day. So what is the action plan? Sattva has to be developed. From today, determine if you are not determined, I am going to do at least one good act. Share, give it to somebody. What you give is up to you. Leave, a flower, a fruit, a cup of water, or some lot of dirt in there, go there and put it in the basket. Some good activity you have, sattvic activity you have. Somebody is not understanding, go and teach. Somebody is there who is not able to walk, help them to walk. Somebody is wanting to go in the wheelchair, help them. In whatever way, you can help, develop the positive. This is how you take an action plan. And write down in your diary. Every day you must write your diary and do this. And to spread this positivity everywhere. Send your WhatsApp, send your SMS to the people. Then the positivity will spread. And see that day by day you start developing positivity. Sattva is going to grow. Then rajas is going to come down automatically. Sattva is, tamas is going to come down. This is a simple thing by which you can start practice of karma yoga. And imagine, if everybody wants to give, how wonderful can be the society. Now what has happened, everybody wants more and more for me. As a result, they become very selfish, all corruptions and scams, everything is all due to that. And correspondingly, all the diseases are due to that. So start reversing, you start developing. We can not only develop ourselves, we can create ideal social orders. Therefore, our ancient seers and rishis said, what are the twin ideals in this nation? Tyaga and Seva. Swami Vivekananda said, renunciation and service are the twin ideals of this nation. And if you have to develop India, you have to raise India to the highest height, these things should be brought forward. So this can happen only when we all start one by one. We and me. Every one of us should determine this is the course of yoga. Let's contemplate on this thought. Sit tight with the eyes closed. Relax all parts of the body from toes to head. Beautiful smile on the face. Tamas makes you sleepy, drowsy, lazy, lethargic. They must keep awake. Rajas makes your body very stiff, very tight, full of tension. Face is always grim. Relax. Relax all parts of the body at the key essence of asanas. Relax the face with a beautiful smile on the face. Take a deep breath and slowly breathe out, slowing the breathing. That's the one, the most effective thing to reduce rajas, to reduce the uncontrolled speed of the mind. Very simple. Whenever you are getting very angry, you know you are getting angry, take a deep breath and slowly breathe out. Your anger comes into your control. Very, very, very effective. Then at the mind level, you must purify all good thoughts, sattvic thoughts, just of rajasic action, cut others, beat others, terrorize others, do harm to others. All such thoughts should be vanquished. Develop all good thoughts. How can I do more and more? Better things for the society, good for others, for the nation, for the world. What can I do? What can I do? And start doing that. The mind level. That is the process of meditation. To reduce the kleshas, dhyana. Dhyana heyava. Towards this wonderful path of yoga given by our ancient seers, rishis, Patanjali, Krishna Bhagavan and others, and ennoble ourselves, divinize ourselves, and see that we become better human beings, great, super, divine human beings, day by day. Come to Namaskara Mudra.